Good morning, friends. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. So let's begin this video. But before that, if you're a newcomer here, then do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can just connect with us directly. And you can also enjoy the free quizzes that we provide on this group. So guys, this is the new course for RBI Grade B that we have launched. In this course, you will get PDFs, videos and mock tests. Apart from this, you will also get interview assistance in the form of mock interviews. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your upcoming examination. And let me tell you that the videos of previous interviews have already been uploaded on our channel on YouTube. So if you want to have a glimpse of the type of mock interviews that we conduct, you can just go to the videos. You can just watch those videos. Right now, we will be sending you basically a book kit that will contain all the books mentioned in this slide. And apart from this, we are also running a 30% discount on this course. So these are the two bonuses that you will get after enrolling in the new course. And you can just avail this 30% discount by using the RBI30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can use to call us if you have any kind of query. So that was the introduction. Now let's begin the video with the first question. Which state has launched Sanjeevani Pariyojana to provide medical care to people in district in home isolation and having mild and moderate COVID-19 symptoms? Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Haryana and Punjab are in the options. And out of these options, the right answer here is option D, Haryana. So Haryana has launched this Sanjeevani Pariyojana in collaboration with a company. And what is the name of that company? The name of the company is Deloitte. Okay, so that was all about this question. There is nothing much that you can remember from this news. Okay, the next question is important. Who is the president of FIH? First of all, FIH is the International Hockey Federation, which is located in Switzerland. And the exact location of this organization is your task to find out. You have to tell me the city where this FIH is located. I have told you the country. Switzerland is the headquarters of FIH. Now coming back to the question, who is the president of FIH? Basically, elections were held recently in FIH and Narendra Batra became the president of FIH for a second term. So basically, he has been reappointed as the president of FIH, that is International Hockey Federation. Now guys, you should also know this fact that Narendra Batra is the first ever Indian who became the first person in 2016 to head this international organization. So basically, he became the first Indian to head the international organization of an Olympic sport. So this hockey is an Olympic sport, and he became the first person to be the president of the international organization handling that sport. I hope that you can understand this well. So we have discussed everything related to FIH, and now I expect the answers from you guys. Where is the exact location, exact headquarters of FIH? Because cities are also important. Now, next question is, who has been appointed as the CEO of Reserve Bank Innovation Hub? So this Innovation Hub, if you remember, it was very much in the news. We have already discussed this last year. So Reserve Bank Innovation Hub was announced last year. And what is the purpose of this hub? That we will discuss a little later. But first, let's discuss the CEO of this hub. So we have five options: Gyan Bhushan, Rajesh Bansal, R.K. Bharti, Pranav Prakash, Sushila Tikka. Out of these options, the right answer is option B, that is Rajesh Bansal. So he has been appointed as the CEO of this Innovation Hub, which was announced in the year 2020. Now guys, what is the purpose of this Innovation Hub? This is basically to promote innovation, promote research in the field of finance technology, fintech. In the field of fintech, this in order to promote innovation technology, this Reserve Bank Innovation Hub has been established. The previous CEO of this Reserve Bank Innovation Hub was Chris Gopalakrishnan. So if you remember, we had already discussed this question. Now, I would like to tell you guys that Rajesh Bansal was a former member of UIDAIT. UIDAI refers to Unique Identification Authority of India. And he was a member of the team of UIDAI. What is the use of telling you this? The use is that my next question is coming from that information only. So you have to tell me the recent person who has been appointed as the CEO of UIDAI. This is also an important appointment and we had discussed it. Okay. So now it is your task that you have to find out and tell me in the comment section below. And I hope that majority of you would remember it and don't have to Google it. Okay. Chalo. Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following has won the Best Biodiversity Management Committee Award at the 5th edition of India Biodiversity Awards? So there is a lot that I'm going to tell you in this question, but first of all, let's discuss the answer. So we have five biodiversity management committees in the options, and out of these five committees, the right answer is option A, Shergaon Biodiversity Management Committee, which is in Arunachal Pradesh. So let me first tell you that this is the first BMC from Arunachal Pradesh that has got this award, the India Biodiversity Award, in the category of Best Biodiversity Management Committee. Now, let's first discuss something about this award, then we will move on to the list of winners in this award, because this is just one category that has got award, but there are other categories as well that we need to look on. But first, let's discuss about this award. So India Biodiversity Awards is basically a joint initiative of Ministry of Environment, National Biodiversity Authority, and United Nations Development Programme. So these three organizations have come together to launch this India Biodiversity Awards, and this is the fifth edition of this award. So remember this fact about this India Biodiversity Award. Now, from the name itself, it is clearly stating the purpose of the awards, that is to recognize the efforts of organizations as well as individuals who are doing great in the field of biodiversity conservation. So that is the whole purpose, or we can say that was the whole background of this India Biodiversity Awards. Now let's move on to the 2021 list of winners. So these are the different categories and the winners vis-a-vis. But remember guys, the list is very long, but I have picked up only the most important awards here. So the important ones I have picked up, but the whole list is very large. Okay, so let's discuss the awards. First is Biodiversity Management Committee. We have discussed it. It is the first from Arunachal Pradesh. Next award is in the category of Sustainable Use of Biological Resources, which has been won by this organization from Rajasthan. Next is Sustainable Use of Biological Resources, the same category, but in the individual subcategory. So it has been won by S. Satish, who is a forest range officer of Ramanathapuram, subdivision of Gulf Mannar Marine National Park. Now guys, you should also know where this national park is located, and find it and tell me in the comment section below. Next category is Conservation of Domesticated Species, which has been won by Shaji N. Nam, NM, and he is also known as the Tuber Man of Kerala. Remember this accolade that is associated with this man. Okay, next is Sustainable Use of Biological Resources, which has been won by again an organization which is from Nagaland. So this is the name of this organization, and here the list of winners which are important for us has ended. Now we are moving on to the next question. Which lab of DRDO has developed DIPCOVAN, an antibody detection kit for SARS-CoV-2 virus? So guys, you would be knowing this fact that SARS-CoV-2 virus is the real reason behind COVID-19 disease, and this DIPCOVAN is nothing but a detection device for COVID-19 disease. Now, which lab of DRDO has developed it? We have five options right in front of us. The right answer here is option D. Defense Institute of Physiology and Allied Services, it has developed this DIPCOVAN, and it has collaborated with an organization to develop this DIPCOVAN, to Vanguard Diagnostic Private Limited. So Vanguard Diagnostic and this Defense Institute of Physiology and Allied Services have partnered in order to launch this DIPCOVAN, which is basically a detection kit for COVID-19 disease. So here we have discussed all the questions for the day. Now my question from you is that you have to tell me the chief of DRDO who is presently heading this organization. This is your question for the day, and let's say goodbye to each other on that note. I hope that you all stay healthy, keep studying, and stay motivated. Thank you so much for watching the video.